Greetings, Oitlands. Greetings, Lambs. Today's lesson is about Kathy Shanahan, 1958. My family had a year thitherto moved into a house in Woodacres, Maryland, which was situated in the highest point in the Washington, D.C. metropolitan area. Not the house, but the neighborhood was. We lived on one end next to a small driveway that rose into a small parking lot for the playground and athletic fields of the elementary school, which was across the fields. We were situated on the top of a huge vein of quartz, it appears, which stuck out next to it came out of the ground near the school. Children used to find quartz crystals there. They'd rise out of the ground from time to time. When we first moved there, they were cleaned out within a year or two after we moved there. And there was iron ore in the soil. So where there was a stream bed where the little runnels ran down the playground during the rain only, there was sand with iron ore, and the children used to take magnets and take the little bits of iron ore out of the sand. So that's the nature of the earth where we abode. At the other end of the street, which was just over two blocks long, it was a hilly street. It rose up to a ridge and then back down again. The street intersected Massachusetts Avenue, which was a road that ran from the middle of Washington, D.C. out almost as far as Glen Echo Amusement Park in Montgomery County, Maryland, 2 miles outside of the D.C. border and about 2 miles away from Georgetown University. So since we were so close to Georgetown University, and since it was a middle-class neighborhood, some of the top political Roman Catholics on earth lived there. They were connected with Georgetown University, and they were all prosperous enough to send their children to parochial schools. Now, I don't know anything about Kathy Shanahan's family, but she lived in the house on the same side of Wynwood Road as ourselves, but on the opposite end, where it joined Massachusetts Avenue. Her house faced Massachusetts Avenue, and I never met her, but I admired her. I didn't long for her or think about her very often, but whenever I'd see her, I would get an admiring feeling. I was only 10 years old, as I said. I didn't reach puberty till I was 14, so this was sort of a childish I was born with Venus conjunct Neptune, which is tends to hold love in the imagination without necessarily externalizing it into the real world, so-called. So I was capable of having a crush on Kathy Shanahan that would last for 20 seconds and then forgetting about her after that. So she went to the church of the little, I mean to a school called Little Flower School that adjoined the Church of the Little Flower, which was downhill from Western Junior High School, both of which were off of Massachusetts Avenue. And Western Junior High School I eventually went to a few years afterward. And that's the same school that Maria Shriver went to, who was younger than myself. I didn't know her. I was gone by the time she went to there. And when she went to there, I believe the name had been changed to something else. But when I went, it was Western Junior High School. Oh. So I used to see Kathy Shanahan, and I don't know how I knew her name since I never met her. I didn't. Our families didn't know each other. I used to see her coming and going, either going between house and car or car and house. She had freckles and sort of golden brown hair, like brown with blonde highlights. And I thought she was very, very cute. But like I said, I didn't think about her very often, only when I would see her normally. So during the summertime, as my mother recommended, I was very bad with heat. To me, heat was torture. We didn't have air conditioning. Nobody had air conditioning. The schools did not have air conditioning. The businesses did not have air conditioning. This was 1958, summertime. And I just remember feeling like almost like you're being burned at the stake or somehow being tortured whenever the temperature would get very high. I guess with the right diet and the right herbs, I might not have felt that way. Because it doesn't bother me as much now as it did then. I remember like 10 years after that, maybe 6 years after that, going hiking in that kind of weather and being in the sun and exerting myself and getting very hot and actually enjoying it, sort of. So I don't know what the factor, the health, I'm talking about health now. What if it was the amount of exercise I was getting or something changed in my diet or just maturation, or maybe it was desensitization. Or acclimation. I might have eventually acclimated to that kind of weather. My family comes from Swedish and British Isles on my mother's side, and a little bit so on my father's side. So I might have been genetically not predisposed to suffer heat very well. So one in 1958, the song by Jerry Butler and the Impressions came out. So my bedroom was in the basement. We lived on a slope, so there was a window, not one of these windows near the ceiling, but a full house window clear down to maybe 3 or 4 feet off the floor. So I could see the shrubbery outside. It was a fairly pleasant view. And I had a big old radio that I never was aware of what channel it was on. I would just scroll through up and down the spectrum until I heard a song that I wanted to stay with. So one day, did I say I went to public school? Kathy went to private school. I never met her. Somehow I knew her name, and I'd see her coming and going from a distance, from maybe 20, 30, 40 yards away. But one day, I was in the basement listening to the radio, and the song came on, "For Your Precious Love" by Jerry Butler and the Impressions. And somehow I knew that she was listening to it.
Your precious love means more to me than any when I wanted you, I was so lonely and so blue for that.
So, with the Venus and Neptune, I was able to tune in. I felt like she and I were both thinking of each other. And in a sort of a loving way, romantic and loving, but also we were thinking of Jesus. We were loving each other and we were loving Jesus. And we were loving Jerry Butler. I know that this was happening. She didn't really mean that much to me normally, but I felt like I couldn't have felt that way about somebody at that moment without them sharing it. It wasn't the kind of feeling that you there was a devotion to Jesus. So maybe, you know, you could theorize Jesus was bringing us together on a spiritual plane because we were two people who were devoted to him. Not much else to say. So if you want to find out more about me, Here's how you, I'll show you how to do it. I'll show you. There's a website that has my short bio on it, which is a little bit longer than it was supposed to be. And here's, there it is. Whee! Just don't put an L in Keesey if you want to get there. Thank you for coming.